Welcome back, everybody. You are listening to Portia Amare on Female Soul Society here on Love the Beat Radio. Thank you so much for all sticking with me and on to the next segment of the show. So delighted, as always, to have this very special segment, our Superwoman of the Week. Are we ready? Oh, yes. Wonderful. Like I say, thank you so much for everyone that's sticking with me and here connecting with female artists. We're empowering them. We're listening to their stories. We're listening to the music that's got them through their amazing journeys. And we have an amazing superwoman this week, as we do every single week. But I'm delighted to have the incredible Alicia Sedgwick. She's literally doing so many exciting things and has done throughout her career. She's about to release her very first book on Amazon, and it's called Communicating Through Change, and it's out on January the 19th. So do look out for it. I'm going to give her a quick call, and we're going to talk about everything that she's been up to. Now, she's been teaching public speaking at the International University of Monaco. She found out firsthand during the lockdown in early 2020 that she needed to completely revamp how she taught her courses to dozens of students no longer allowed into the classroom or even into the country. I mean, so many challenges that people have been faced with. What she's done is she's created these particular training programs to help camera shy corporate CEOs to make sure that they look professional and convincing on things like Zoom and other online platforms. And she's written this book in order to give others hope, resilience, and a clarity about how to move forward. And she said, Communicating Through Change, which is the title of her book, helps you to find your inner strength and to speak up for yourself. So without further ado, let me give her a call and we'll get her on the phone. And I'm really excited for you all to meet an amazing woman. Now, this is an international dialing tone. Here we go. Hello, Alicia. Oh, we're just having a connection issue. Bear with us. Alicia, can you hear me?
Hello.
Hi.
I can hear you.
Oh, wonderful. There
Hello.
We are. Oh, welcome to Female
there
Soul Society.
Thank you.
You are our Superwoman of the Week. I mean, you're a superwoman every single week of the year, obviously. But it's lovely to have you featured at such a special time. Everything that you're putting out, which you've always putting out such I've just given you a big intro and on your amazing new book coming out on January 19th, Communicating Through Change. But first of all, let me ask you, how are you doing? How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. Thank you. Lovely, lovely Portia. I'm so delighted to be able to speak to you. How fantastic is this? Who can believe it?
We're making it happen, Alicia. I mean,
yeah.
I've not seen you in a long time, and I know that we've remained to stay in touch and follow and support each other through these very challenging, interesting times. And to have your support, it's encouraged me to keep going. So how wonderful to connect in this way and to celebrate, like I say, this amazing achievement of yours.
Thank you so much. Well, I'm so happy to follow you and your success and everything that you have achieved and continue to. And when I think about when I met you so many years ago, and now here we both are, I just think it's wonderful.
It really is. It is. And let's talk about the journey. I mean, as you know, on my show, Female Soul Society, it's music-led in the way that obviously music really inspires me and obviously inspires everyone. The world is not the world without music. And we all have certain songs that inspire us, and we will be playing some of your song choices.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, thank you. They're all great. They're all brilliant song choices. We'll have a dance listening to these. Let's talk a bit about kind of before the book and the work that you've been doing. I'd mentioned that you've been obviously a lecturer and you've been helping people communicating online with everything that's been going on this year. And you've also been a part of TEDx Monte Carlo, which is, I bow down to you for being a part of that. And I remember speaking to you actually about it when you very first got asked to be a part of TEDx. And I was like, Alicia, this is huge. And now, not only have you worked with them, but you've also co-curated Monaco's first TEDx youth event.
Yes, I'm about to. Yes, absolutely. So you're perfectly correct. What I've been doing in recent years is teaching public speaking and presentation skills, and really developing that into communication skills. And I first started teaching at the International University of Monaco, and I taught one class of undergrads. That's how it started. Now I teach several classes of undergrads. I teach master's students and MBA students. I also teach public speaking and communication skills at the International School of Monaco. And privately, I do training and coaching in communication. Wow. And in this last year, that really developed to helping people to be effective and make an impact on camera and online. I mean, I was doing that anyway, but of course, with us all being now communicating through Zoom and Teams and other platforms, our meetings are on camera, online. Our communication is very, very much now online and not in person. So really helping people with their confidence and to be able to, like I say, communicate effectively and make an impact. And it's been wonderful for me to really help people. You know that I'm all about helping people and supporting them and seeing them build in their confidence, particularly over the last year when things have been so uncertain and people have really needed help. It's been amazing. And yes, I am the MC for TEDx Monte Carlo. We did an event online last year in November, which actually was 6 hours online that I was MCing and hosting. Wow. That, which was, that was quite a challenge, but it was wonderful. It was actually to do with the theme was fearless, but it was all to do with TEDx women. So that was very dear to my heart. And yes, I started working with the International School of Monaco to put on the first ever TEDx youth event, which was supposed to be in October last year, but now it's going to be in February this year, and it's actually going to be online because of COVID and all the restrictions. So that's a great pleasure for me to work with the students, because it is student-led. Mm-hmm. We have a couple of adults on the committee, but it's student-led, and it's going to be student speakers, and how fabulous to be able to work with them and to put that on.
It's amazing.
It's very, very exciting.
So all of your work, everything you've ever applied yourself to, and whenever I've met you in person, we've sat down, had conversation, I've always left feeling empowered. And so it's you really have this natural and beautiful gift. I think these students are, you know, some of the luckiest students out there to have you mentor them and help them.
Thank you.
I would say, you know, my question to you would be, obviously through this, you've been learning about connecting with your students online as well. And have you, you know, by mentoring other people, has that kind of inspired you, or have you had to look in other directions or to other people, you know, for advice or anything like that, you know, in this time, because it's all been brand new, you know? How do you really feel someone's emotion, you know, because we're all having such high days and low days, you know, it's such a roller coaster when you're educating somebody. How do you kind of engage with them and get to know where they're at, you know?
Yes. And you're absolutely right. And I must admit that when it first happened last year, I went from almost 1 week that I was teaching in person to the next week that everything went online. Mm-hmm. So it was an incredible learning curve for me. The wonderful thing was that I was at home and so was my beloved Annette. Mm-hmm. And so she really helped me to put my training online, to make videos for the training. And she was my inspiration and motivation as always, and really helped me to get through it all. And then, you know, with that kind of support, I can then go forward and to give the support to my students who, of course, young and old, or older, should I say, young and older, that, you know, they were all experiencing that it was very different for them. Yeah. And so to be able to actually learn how to use these platforms and also to schedule their time to be able to then go for the various means of communication and to really work through it all, it was very important that, you know, I stayed positive and that I could be there for them and to be able to help them through the journey as I was going through the journey myself. But, you know, I'm always very open and communicate how I feel. Yeah. So that they knew that they weren't alone and that I understood what they were going through, because I was going through it myself very often.
Well, exactly. And there's comfort in that, you know, knowing that we're all, you know, if we can be as transparent as possible, that, you know, I'm struggling today, or I'm having some technical issues, or I'm struggling to read, you know, how this is going to go today. So let's all get there together. I think that's there's beauty in that, isn't it? Because we can all kind of grow together, even though we're all at different phases in our life. Yeah.
Yes, very much, very much. And I think as well that it was important to be able to say to my students, look, you don't have to get this in very speedy time. You know, take the time and actually use this time to take the time, because it was very much about being rather than doing. And for me, you know, that's been a very big lesson through I've had some health issues, which people who know me know that I have had that, and indeed I talk about it in my book because it is one of the changes that I've been through that I speak about. And going through that, it does make you realize that we are human beings and not human doings, and that actually we should take the time to be. And so for me, the message for my students was, look, don't feel overwhelmed, don't feel stressed out by the fact that this seems to be all coming at you at once. Take your time. This is the time that you can do that. So remember that you are a human being and not a human doing.
That's amazing. I think every listener right now will be fully taking that on board. And I know I needed to hear that as well today. So thank you for that wonderful insight into your teaching and your mentoring there. And sending a big loving shout out to Annette, because I know how important it is for us at this time to have that rock in our lives, you know, and our support network. When we do feel a bit wobbly, we have that constant love and support, and that's how we're able to continue to give out to others.
Thank you.
Yeah, wonderful.
Thank you. I know that she'll appreciate that, and I know that she appreciates you. So we've had so many happy times together, and we so adore seeing you perform and seeing your progress. So thank you.
Well, thank you, Alicia. Well, let's play a song. Now, you've given me a few here.
Yes.
One of the songs, I think we should start with a bit of Barbra Streisand, The Way We Were. An amazing song. Why did you choose this song?
I love Streisand. Mm. So she had to be on my playlist. but this particular song, it's because it really is, it's about my life really with my mum and dad, because this was like my theme tune that I would sing. As you know, I have sung blues and ballads. And
yes.
When I was 18, actually, I remember I sang The Way We Were at the Pontins Holiday Camp talent competition, which I won singing that song.
Of course you did.
and so it became the song that I would sing very often during my set list, and mum and dad loved it, and they would love me to sing it. So it's really on the list because it's in my heart, and all to do with mum and dad, who are always with me even though they're not here physically anymore.
Oh, what a lovely dedication. Well, let's play Barbra Streisand, The Way We Were, for your wonderful parents and the memory of you singing it at Pontins, number one prize. Here we
Thank
go.
Thank you.
absolutely beautiful. Barbara Streisand. Oh,
takes me back. That takes me back. My goodness. I remember actually it was, I was 18 and I fell in love with Rowley, the entertainment manager, blue coat at the Pontius Holiday Camp. And so, you know, when I hear that song, I not only think about Mum and Dad, but I think about Rowley.
Oh, love to Rowley and his blue coat, feeling $1 million. I mean, because it was always a battle, wasn't it, between the red coats and the blue coats. You're obviously a Ponting girl. Whereabouts did you go? Which Ponting side?
That one was actually, it was Ossington Bay, which was in Dorset. And it was an over 18s one. So, yes, it was lovely. Actually, Rowley turned out to be quite a rogue, so we won't go there.
Why am I not surprised?
I should have known.
I know. It's all for the memoirs, all for the book, which you've done. it says in the write-up about your amazing new book, Communicating Through Change, that you talk intimately about the loss of loved ones and life-threatening illnesses and risky lifestyle changes. So I'd love to, you can share and divulge as much or as little as you want. Obviously, we don't want to give too much away. But, you know, like say you've had such an amazing and colourful life and you've always faced it head on and fearlessly. That's what I feel. Would you say that's accurate?
I think you're absolutely right, yes. You know, I was very blessed to have wonderful parents who always supported and encouraged me and gave me confidence and also had an incredible joie de vivre despite the tragedies in their life, which also impacted mine. It was always that we were to make the most of life and everything. So that gave me, if you like, the courage and positivity to face whatever came my way. And as the book documents, yes, there's been a lot of changes. And the purpose of the book is that I share my personal experience of those changes, which have been traumatic and had a really big impact, but it's what I've learnt through that, and then to be able to help my reader to learn as well and to be able to embrace those changes, because most of the changes will affect the reader at some time in their life, because yes, it talks about bereavement, loss of parents. It actually talks about loss of a sibling, which I hope people don't go through. But if they do, then there's that chapter. There's aging. There's living through a pandemic. Lots of changes which people can relate to and understand. And it will give them techniques and ways of being able to then deal with those changes and cope with them, giving practical exercises and tips and affirmations for them to follow, so that when they are going through that experience, that book is there to help them, support them and guide them. And I hope that what will happen with the book is that when you read it, even if a particular chapter, you don't relate to it now in your life, you'll think further on when that experience happened, oh yes, Alicia wrote about that, I'll go back to it and see what she said. And anyway, it will help you generally in life, because it gives you communication techniques and it helps you to understand, even if you're not going through the experience, that somebody that you love or you care for is. Mm. And so how do you approach it to help and support them? So,
and we need all of those. We need all the help we can get. And like you say, life brings changes anyway, but we've been kind of forced into every, for some of us, every single part of our normal life has completely changed upside down. And maybe one change, as awful as it would be, you know, to obviously lose somebody or lose a job, or but for this is happening in every kind of section of people's lives. So it's very generous of you to share your story and how you've coped, and I'm sure it will help many people. And I will be ordering my copy on Amazon. January 19th, it will be coming through my door. I can't wait to read it.
Thank you. Well, I just felt that it was very important to express my vulnerabilities, to show that there is strength in that, because after everything that I have been through, I am still here smiling, laughing, motivating, inspiring, encouraging, and so I wanted that to be the message, that even when you are vulnerable and even when you feel that you are in a position of perhaps weakness, that actually there is strength. And also there is always my support, because I understand and I'm there for you. And my team, Alicia, which I always create in my training, Team Alicia is there for you too. So I think that it's very, very timely. I do think that's why I wanted the book to be out as soon as possible this year, because it's so very, very relevant and pertinent for now when we are in such a period of uncertainty and change.
And it's that thing of whether, you know, it, I know I've certainly felt it, but it's like sink or swim, you know, fight or flight at the moment. And I think when you have the correct tools and the correct information and the correct support, then you naturally, in whatever pace you want to do it, you do need to keep moving, and you can't let this whole thing consume you, because it doesn't end well, and it's so quick. You know, one minute you can be feeling good, and if you haven't got those correct tools in place, just one thing or just a small thing going wrong, it can just tip you over the edge. So these life skills are so important, and I'm hoping this book will go to as many people as possible, because, like I say, I know it's coming from such an honest and true human, and how lovely that you can also pass it on to all of your students. I'm sure it's advice you've given to them in many a class, but still, it's great to have the hard copy. And that was something I was going to ask. Have you always wanted to write a book, or has it come out of 2020 and all of the challenges? Did you think?
I don't think that I did always want to write a book. Funny enough, I was always told that I would write a book and that I could write a book, but it never really was on my radar, to be honest. But then, last year in August, I just suddenly felt I wanted to express my personal experience of change, and so I wrote that out, and that kind of flowed, and it was actually quite cathartic, I must say, to get that out, express some things which I hadn't expressed, that had laid very, very deep within me, as you will see when you read the book, some of the chapters. And so just expressing that was very, very healing for me. And then it was a question of, okay, you know, how can I now turn this into something where it's going to be healing and helpful for people to receive? And so I got in touch with a friend of mine. Her daughter is a very, very successful brand builder, and Sammy Blindell. And she, I knew that she would put me in the right direction, and indeed she did. She got me in touch with Wendy York, who is a literary agent and author coach. And Wendy and I just absolutely clicked, and she was was wonderful. And she then helped me to structure the book in such a way that my experience could be turned into something very constructive and helpful for a big global audience. And that's really how then Communicating Through Change came about, because it was using all of the skills that I am teaching and turning it into a way of using those skills and those techniques for other people through change, which is the one thing that we can be sure of in this life. Mm. So yes, so I think, funnily enough, you know, I started writing that in August. The book was then finished and ready for publication by October, November.
That was ridiculously fast.
Yeah. So I think that it just showed how it was meant to be. Absolutely. And once that happened, funnily enough, once I then was writing it, I did feel, gosh, yes, this is something that I should have been doing, that I could have been doing, but it was the right time for it. So everything fell into place, and that's why I think it was written so quickly as well, because it was truly meant to be. So, so maybe yes, all of those years of being told that I should and I could write a book, actually, yes, I did, and it was absolutely right that I did. And I really do believe. I do believe that it is going to be so helpful globally, because it is something that affects everyone all over the world, just as the way that COVID-19 has. It is a global pandemic. This book is going to help people globally as well, because what it's talking about resonates with anyone anywhere in the world.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. And you know, one of the songs that you chose for your playlist is Faith, and yes. I believe that, you know, that's such, I mean, there's kind of a lot of affirmations that kind of putting out there at the moment, peace being one of them, and hope, and having faith, having that faith within ourselves, within the world, that things will get better, we need as much as that positive vibration as possible. So I'd love to now go into playing that song, and keep that high vibration that you've set on this show, Alicia.
Thank you.
With George Michael. So here we go.
gotta have faith. I gotta have faith. Because I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith. I gotta have faith, the faith, the faith.
I mean, I hope you're dancing away there in Monaco, Alicia. I'm dancing away here in London.
I certainly am. You know what I was going to say to you? I hope that you're dancing.
Oh, you love a good move. I know that you're always moving, exercising, zumbering, singing, all of these things. And I'm sure that's absolutely why you're always shining so bright and smiling. You know, movement and everything is so important, wanting to do that. Yeah, it feels so good. I'm so delighted with these song choices.
Good.
Now, you've already had an early pre-publication review, and it reads that Alicia Sedgwick has created a new genre of self-change, and her writing shares personal experiences written for real people who want to make real changes. And I think that's a really important part to this, is that you have to show up and personally, and you have to do the work. You know, you're giving out this information, but for people who are reading the book, you know, well, if you're reading it, you obviously want the change. I always think that if you're listening to this and you're sticking with us, you obviously want to hear about, you know, new ways to feel better. But that is a really important part to kind of self-development, isn't it?
I think it is important, but I think that it's also that you accept and you acknowledge the change. And, you know, sometimes in terms of moving forward, it takes that you actually acknowledge it and you accept it to be able to move forward. So I think that, yeah, it is about self-change, but it's about being able to understand what's happening and understanding as well that sometimes you don't need to actually do anything. Again, it comes back to this being and being accepting and being that you acknowledge that things are going on for you and that you perhaps don't feel comfortable and you want to feel comfortable and you don't know how to feel comfortable. So then, you know, all of that is in the book to be able to help you accept that things are going on, acknowledging that things are going on, and accepting that maybe you don't want it to be going on and you do want to do something about it, but you don't know what to do about it. And maybe as well that sometimes that what it takes is that actually you just sit very quietly and you learn to embrace what you are feeling so that you can then move on and then you can express it. So I think that in many ways, you used a word at the start of our conversation today about me, which I really loved, which was empowering. And I think that that is what the book is all about too, that it is empowering, that it gives you the strength to be able to cope with and deal with the change that is happening for you. And you can take control. So I think the self-change comes in you being able to take control of yourself and the situation and knowing that you can do that. And that then reduces that it becomes overwhelming and that it becomes that you feel I'm totally out of control and I don't know how to deal with this. And it feels like a wave that keeps hitting me and hitting me and hitting me. Mm-hmm. And I don't know how to get up and to swim through it mm-hmm. or to surf it. So it will give you the strength and the ability and the tools to be able to do that.
Fantastic. I mean, what a way to start the year. I mean, to have you know, to have heard now the process, obviously most of this all of this experience that's gone into the book has been your life so far, but it's all come together so quickly, and how wonderful and inspiring that you've managed to get this together, and it's out there at the beginning of this year. It's still not going to be an easy ride, but you know, life isn't an easy ride, and I'm sure this will make us stronger. And as you say, we're learning so much about ourselves, and we've been forced to be still many times, and alone with our thoughts, which has been, I will speak from my own experience, has been scary sometimes. And you know, we're just so used to distractions from many different kind of sources, you know, it's been still, and I'm kind of seeing it as a, what's the word when you kind of suspended, just before you're about to swing forward, you know, and you kind of suspended back. I feel like we're all kind of being pulled back, and if we can breathe through it, when we get to move again, we should flow with kind of a whole new fresh energy, and that's what I'm hoping. But I'm also so aware that I couldn't do this alone. And I don't think any of us can. And so I just want to say thank you so much for offering such a generous gift to the world with your experience and your wisdom and your empowerment. And I wish you all the success with it. And I mean, it's already a success. It's there. It's ready to go. But I just can't wait to see where it goes from here, Alicia. It's been amazing.
Well, thank you, Portia. Yeah. Thank you so much. I really do appreciate your love and support, and you know that it comes right back at you too, for everything that you're doing and all the light that you give to everyone through your music, through what you're doing here, and you know, I mean, you're constantly always shining a light, and I'm so proud that I can be part of that light, and that together today we're shining it very, very brightly. And you know, yes, I want my readers to feel my embrace, because that really is what the book is doing. It's helping them to embrace change, and I'm embracing them through that. And I'm certainly embracing you today too.
Thank you, Alicia. I feel it. I'm sure every listener feels it too. Your warmth, your support, and again, and I'm sure they're going to go out there and buy it. But I will say it one more time that it is on sale on Amazon, starting January 19th. So check it out. Correct. And Alicia said, .com.
Can I just say, sorry, Portia, that if people do want to contact me as well, my website is www.aliciasedgwick.com, and I'll be delighted to hear from you even before you read the book, but certainly afterwards too. And, you know, I'm always here to help people with their communication skills and speaking in public, speaking online, giving people a voice, their voice, so that they can really express themselves clearly and effectively. So, that's really what I'm about too. So, thank you for listening to my voice today and to my music choices too.
Oh, I know. Well, we're going to have one more song, and I will play some other of the songs. But what would you like your final song to be? We have a couple left. I mean, is there one in particular? We have Trisha Yearwood.
The Trisha Yearwood, I'll Still Love You More, is really about my love. My beloved Annette, it's our song together. So I think I'll say that. And Annette, I do still love you more. I didn't think that was possible, but every day, I just love you more and more and more. But maybe we should end on Bruno Mars' 24 Karat Magic, because we want to spread a little magic. You know, my teaching is the theme tune is Bruno Mars' 24 Karat Magic, because, you know, I say to my students that when you see a magician do their magic tricks, you think, how do they do it? And what I do in my teaching for their communication skills is to get them to be able to speak and communicate so that people say, how do they do it? So 24 karat magic, and also because being in Team Alicia is magical, because you're in an environment where you're totally supported and cared for, and you can be yourself without inhibition and without worries and cares and fears. So I think 24 karat magic, Bruno Mars should be the song to finish, because we need to spread a little magic.
Oh, you have spread the magic today, Alicia. Thank you for being our Superwoman of the Week here on Female Soul Society. I'm bursting with joy and inspiration from this conversation we've just had. And anyone that wants to connect and has missed the links, they will be on my page on Instagram, on Female Soul Society. Everywhere you can find Alicia, you'll be able to find there, and the link to the book as well. And I'm sure they'll all be rushing to connect with you. So let's have a boogie. Let's keep spreading the magic. And congratulations on your amazing new book. Sending you
lots
of love.
Thank you, Portia. I'm smiling so broadly. Thank you. I love you.
I love you too. Here we go.
Yeah.
Wow, wow. What an interview with our Superwoman of the Week, Alicia Sedgwick, talking about her amazing new book, Communicating Through Change. I'm so inspired after that, and I'm sure you all are too. And like I say, please do head over to my Instagram page, Female Soul Society, and I will have all of the information about Alicia's work, her website, and where you can purchase her book. It was truly magical, and I think if she'll be listening back to this with her love, it would only be right that we play the beautiful song, I'll Still Love You More, just because it was so romantic. And I dedicate this to your love and say thank you so much for speaking with us today, Alicia. So here we go.
Ask me how much you mean to me, and I wouldn't even know where to start. Ask if this love runs deep in me, you won't find a deeper love in any heart. You could say tell you I would do anything. Ask if this heart beats true for you, and I'll show you a truer heart could never be. You could say there's not a star that you won't bring me. You could say
thank you so much to all of our wonderful listeners, to our wonderful guests, Superwoman of the Week, Alicia Sedgwick, sending you lots of love. And remember, love always prevails. Until next time, this has been Female Soul Society on Love the Beat Radio. Take care.